I'm here today in Manchester at the Protest the Tory conference demo, and I'm here today because I'm angry. In fact I feel a real rage inside at the moment about the Tories and what they're doing to our most vulnerable in society particularly. But fundamentally underpinning all of this, there is a real feeling of anger about the way that our most marginalised, our most vulnerable are just being left to slip through the net. You know, we've got disabled people committing suicide, we've got cancer patients being unable to pay to get to hospitals, we've got nurses who are using food banks. It's just not on, and something's got to change. We want a general election as soon as possible because we need a Labour government. We need a left Labour government that's going to look after our most vulnerable people. There's a lot of people out there who are just falling through, and we need to do something about that. And I think today is a day where we can really show solidarity with those people. I don't want anyone to feel like they've been forgotten, and I don't want anyone to feel like, you know, the world, the country is full of I'm alright jacks. Some people do feel like that, but there's millions and millions who increasingly don't.
£20 billion out of the NHS, and you can do it by making it more efficient, transferring treatment from hospitals to the community, and so on and so forth. And that's the program which, in one way or another, they have been following ever since. The next step on it was in 2012 when the World Economic Forum had a meeting which was coordinated by Simon Stevens. Stevens had been Blair's advisor, and then he went on to become later the head of United Health, the biggest health transnational in the US. Now he is the chief executive of NHS England, and that's the agenda he's following, the agenda that was set by the World Economic Forum in 2012. Why I'm telling you this is because I think people have to understand that this is much more than cuts. This is a plan to dismantle the NHS, and they are using the crisis caused by the collapse of the banks to try to implement this program that they have wanted to do for a very long time. The next important thing to understand is, where is Labour in this story? And it's a very interesting position. On the one hand, Labour councils are complicit in it. Right here in Manchester, they are completely complicit in the devolved bank program, which is carrying out this attack on the NHS. On the other hand, at Labour conference last week, they passed a very important composite 8, which took this whole thing head on. We are now in a position where we can, on the basis of policy adopted unanimously at conference last week, actually attack what the Labour councils are doing. And I think everybody should be doing that, whether you're a member of the Labour Party or not. I'm not. I fight outside in defense of the NHS, and I think that's important. But I think we have to take the fight to the Labour councils, who are defying what is now Labour Party policy. The last thing I want to say is addressed to health workers. You are in a unique situation. Unlike other industrial workers who have faced the sack for taking industrial action, you are irreplaceable. There is no scab army of doctors and nurses waiting to come in. The moment you say that you're not going to implement this plan, it's dead. Please do it.
Hold on, Michelle! Hold on, Michelle! Hold on, Michelle! Java is a region of northern Syria, predominantly Kurdish, but the current movement is multi-religious, it's multi-ethnic, so all peoples of all backgrounds are very, very involved in what's known as direct democracy, and the type of very direct democracy is known as democratic confederalism. So it's a very, very grassroots movement. They have rejected the state because there's currently no state operating in Rojava. People make their own decisions. There's a big focus on a cooperative economy, so private property is not abolished, but it's based on workers' cooperatives, people working together. The land of the former Assad government is now widely being requisitioned and been used for cooperative purposes. It's a huge feminist element to the movement. So immediately on the new movement kind of taking charge when Assad left the area, you know, so women's representation must be heard at all levels of decision making. Decisions can't be made without 40% of those attending being women. Domestic violence has been outlawed, underage marriage, honour-based violence are all outlawed and being very actively acted against at the moment. As you probably know, the huge difficulties in that Rojava is embargoed from all sides, so that makes daily living really challenging. You know, they are being still attacked by Turkey, blockaded from Iraq as well, so it's very, very difficult. And the population is currently, you know, waging a war still against Daesh, ISIS, to the south of.
Hey, hordes, and tory, and stards. Hey, nature. This movement recognizes that capital is like horse shit. If it's piled in a big pile, it stinks. If you spread it out evenly, it makes things grow, right? So let's get the capital not concentrated and centralized, but out into the hands of the people who know how to put it to use and make things grow. Community-supported agriculture, linking customers, families, a few dozen families with a farmer, so you cut the market out of the relationship. It's a direct relationship between the producer and the consumer. The farmer gets a better price and a sure price for their product. The people get the products that they know are grown organically. They can go out to the farm with their children at harvest time, understand the production process. So kids know milk doesn't come from Safeway, it comes from cows. The Tory tax movement, moving to get a tax, a small tax on international currency transactions. The currency markets now, in an average day, are about $1.5 trillion in turnover. That's 1/4 the amount of world trade in goods is in a year. So currency speculation in 4 days does the volume of money that real trade in goods alone does in a year. The amount of money that is now shifted from productive capital sector to finance casino sector is about 40 times as much as in a casino as in the production of real goods and services. That's why all of our goods and services are under attack. And people are starving to death, and there's not enough buying capacity in the hands of people because it's all being sucked into this casino where it doesn't know good for anybody other than the NBA is sitting at a computer clicking away.
I nearly choked on my breakfast this morning when I saw the Tory party conference on TV and a poster outside the conference hall. It said fairness for working people. It's not possible for the Tories to be fair to working people. They're the enemies of low-paid workers. And what I'd like to do today is say a bit about public sector pay. Because you often hear it mentioned that the average public sector worker has lost £3,000 in the last 10 years. Well, just thinking about the cumulative effect of that over the last 10 years. That's £30,000 taken out of the pockets of the average public sector worker and their families. At a time when energy prices are up, pay is down. Fuel is up, pay is down. Housing costs are up, pay is down.
This has been a very, very important march because it's proven that the Tories can't come to Manchester and simply carry on propagating their policy of austerity, measures which are bound to damage the lives of every working people in this country without meeting very, very serious opposition indeed. And that's come from all quarters of the movement, from the trade union movement, from the anti-cuts movement, from the NHS movement, from the anti-war movement, from the campaign for nuclear disarmament, a very, very clear message to the Tories. And it's also very important for the future of the left in this country. We all want to see the Tories driven from power, and many, many people understand that they would like to see a Jeremy Corbyn-led government. But that won't just happen. And it won't just happen by waiting for the next election. It has to be built on the ground through grassroots activity, through support for demonstrations, protests, direct action and strikes. And that was an absolutely central message today here in Manchester.